Playing the Suppy again. Well, like I said, last time he didn't build a spine crawl at all. Which just makes your build a little bit more faster and more efficient. I mean, I lost because I didn't expect him to make the four banelings out of my base right away like that. But taking that risk. Like I said at the start of last game, it's just kind of silly, unnecessary little things that make it even harder to beat him if he gets away with it. This game, I kind of want a dueling baneling attack early on to punish that. And he's always been pretty greedy, so I feel reasonably confident in assuming that he's going to do that again. Actually seen an overlord, but if he were tentpulling, would have seen the circling spine out, so much was kind of down a strange path. So I got this initial tooling coming out. I'll send it out, make it look like a scout. And then just morph the banelings out here. I got 10 more links on the way. And that should be enough to punish him if he is playing greedy. Opening gasless this game. That is annoying. This is another one of those builds that you can just punish really, really easily. But you have to know it's coming. It's so frustrating that he plays like this, because he could be quite a good player. But he's never really going to make it particularly far in tournaments as long as he plays so greedy and risky. We came out pretty even from that, I think. Because he had to invest quite a bit in defense. It's really going to depend on whether or not I can deny his third for a while. Because, of course, he has... Actually, he only has a single Evo upgrades. So it's not going to be too bad. And he's not expanding yet. So that means he's probably going to want to try and do a Roach timing. Might even do a Roach Nidus, actually. Should watch for that. Getting DDoSed. Things seem to be stable for now. Oh, motherfucker. There's a Nidus up here. He plays so dumb. Playing against a Protoss named SWS. It sounds familiar for some reason. Not sure why. I really don't know why this name sticks out in my head. Which scares me, because more often than not, when a random name sounds familiar to me, but I don't know why, it's because they're like a... there's some random unknown players, but they're very cheesy. Because the regular players don't tend to stick in my head. But the ones who cause annoying losses often do. It's also a ZVP on Acolon, so it's just guaranteed to be a fuck anyway. Well, it's a really early probe scout, and honestly I kind of like seeing that early probe scout because it removes the guessing game of should I go... God damn it, fuck off. The guessing game of whether or not you should go hatch first or not. Because if there's no probe scout, it either means that they're going gateway first, expansion, in which case it's 10 times better to go hatch first, or they are going proxy 2 gate, in which case going hatch first is suicidal. So you see that early probe scout and you know that you just go full first into hatchery and everything is going to be about as good as it can get. Sending that probe... Okay, he's going to keep it around here. I did 14 pull, and I do have 6 lanes on the way. I may go try and harass him. Maybe we'll see. The fuck is that? Is that a new graphical bug? I've never seen something like that before. Oh shit. Oh, it's gone now. I hope you guys could see that. Oh, please, God. Damn it. That's not fair. I was distracted by the fact that my queen was fucking tethered to the side of the map. Oh, and I ended up getting 3 probes out of this, so it actually was worthwhile. Thank God he's bad. This game I'm probably gonna do like risky fast muta, because on Aqualon I don't feel like there's anything that's actually good. So something cheesy is the best bet. And fast mute is one of my preferred cheesy builds, CVP. Of course, if he's doing any kind of rush, I'm probably going to be fucked. But if he gets a third base and just sits on it, I'm pretty much fucked anyway. So it's whatever. So all I'm doing is just going straight up to mute it as fast as possible. I'm gonna get some creep out here and I'll drop some spine crawlers, but if he's doing any kind of dedicated two base, he will kill me. It's just a cheesy build. But like I said, the ZVP on Aqualon is kind of a joke, so I don't really feel comfortable going into any kind of real game here. Scouting pretty early on. I'm not sure what that actually was. As far as I know, he's still on 2 base. Which could either be really bad or really good. He's either about to do like a big warp gate base timing, in which case I'm pretty dead. I don't know, he's prepping to take a really late third, which is about the best thing that can happen to me. He's going double star gate. I have an infestation pit. I kind of just want to go. What's the best thing to do here? He's got a robo, he's going immortal. I just do like a big swarm host timing. Need more queens in. Where else would I? What? What kind of question is that? Oh. The fuck? I didn't get a warning about that. My minimap didn't ping at all. The fuck? I have no idea what that was. First the queen bugs out and then that happens. Strange. Be right back. So that was really weird. Is that queen bug like a known graphical thingy? Or have I discovered something new? And no need to watch the replay. I'm not gonna learn anything new from that. Graphics card, huh? That's not good. Searching for another game now. Fog. He's a Lingall NCVZ player. He will occasionally play macro games, but it's a pretty fair bet some cheese is going to come from him. And he's not too amazing at the macro games, although now that ZVZ is kind of returning a roach versus roach, you don't actually have to be amazing to be totally fine. Actually, the last game I think I played against him was a really dumb roach versus roach game on this map. This is the kind of game where both people are constantly attacking, and whoever is defending wins, but not by enough to feel safe to attack or do anything else, or to attack. And then build up a bit, and someone else attacks, and then the same thing happens over and over again. I ended up winning, but it was a really fucking dumb game. Pull first. That's weird. I'm always surprised when people go pull first, especially on a long map like this. 15 hatches literally is absolutely safe against everything on here, as long as you control it well. He has pulled his queen up there to check for my overlord. Whenever anyone does that, it's Sometimes it's just good conscientious play, like denying scouting is always a good thing. But if your overlord isn't actually sitting in range of him, and he actually goes up to check anyway, that often means that they have something to hide. Alright, no, just playing along. See, normal speedling time. Looks like normal everything. This is very, very strange. I think it might be a Baneling all-in. Because he's taking three gases, but he has no tech. Yeah, something's fishy. I'm gonna send some more surfing. It's a scout, but... Something is not right. Nah, it's too late for that, though. Maybe it's just like a delayed defensive roach kind of thing. So yeah, he just delayed his slayer a lot for no real reason. Actually, quick, okay, so I'm pretty sure that's a roach form. So that is what it is. But his lair is so late that he's not going to have a timing before my mutas are out. His roach horn is quite late too, so I'm going to go put pressure on that hatchery. Shouldn't be able to cancel it, but you never know. Maybe he'll fuck up. It's fine though. I'll have enough to clean up. Okay, I have mutas coming now. I just have to buy enough time. I got my bandwidth coming out too. Should be okay. That's an awful lot of wings he made there. Fucked up my hotkeys there for a second, that was almost bad. Oh, he's rushing Hydras. Oh, fuck him. Speed bailing time. This build is so bad, I don't know why anyone does it. Like, it's okay to go roaches into Hydra. And not just straight Hydra like that. So I'm just gonna get some drones at my third base, and then build up a bunch of Ling speed bane. Go kill him. Because when you go straight Hydra like that, there's no possible way to actually have enough gas to get infestors as well. Without the infestors, then you just kind of die to the banelings. Very important to deny scouting though. Just to make sure nothing funky happens. And I want to go right as Speed Baneling finishes. And this is kind of all. Oh shit, I accidentally landed. I let it circling through. And he saw them. That's okay. I don't think he has enough time to repair at this point. Never mind. I did that really badly. I took... Fuck me. It should have been a free win. I took too much damage from the Banelings. That's really bad. I'm probably losing now. God damn it. He is actually still on very low economy. And because he got Banelings and enough Hydras to actually deal with that ship, there's no way he has Infestors anytime soon. So perhaps this could work. Especially if he's just going to donate Hydras. He has quite a few units, so... I don't know. If he doesn't have any more Banelings, I can do it. Oh, especially if he does that. Oh, hello there. Well, that was much closer than it needed to be, but like I said, the fucking Hydra opening does not work. Infestors is too important. Noticed a few people asking about my keyboard. I'm still using the Razer Black Widow Stealth Tournament Edition, so the 10 keyless brown switch mechanical keyboard. And I actually prefer red switches, but I got a red switch, I think it was from Cooler Master, I think. Or CM Star, the team that sponsors Pult, or the company that sponsors Pult. I got one of those, but I didn't like the way that the bottom of the keyboard was set up. It raised my hand too high off the desk and was uncomfortable with the way I set my hand on the keyboard. So I'm still using the brown switch one. But personally, I prefer red switches. Everything else equivalent. I kind of miss my SteelSeries red switch keyboard. The black switch one was so fucking bad, but the red switch one was actually quite good. If you want one that sounds loud, you should get blue switches. Those are the clicky ones. Brown ones are slightly clicky too, but not nearly to the extent that the blue ones are. Blue ones also require a bit more activation force. I think it's only like 5 or 10 grams, but it was enough to make me uncomfortable. Another fucking CVP on Acolyte. Hopefully I'll see the Warp Prisma main this game before it kills every single drone. Another early probe scout. Oh, can you guys still not hear the music, or did that fix itself? I completely forgot that that was a problem. Okay, everyone says we can't. If I remember, I'll try and fix that next week, but I have actually no clue why it's not working. So my attempts to fix it probably won't be too effective. Oh wow, I got 3 building cancels out of them. That actually ended up being quite worth it. For 2 lings. Just a pylon kill plus that. Another important thing to note is that he didn't actually see this third base. He came and checked at normal timing, but since I had gone 14 pull, mine was a little bit delayed and I hit the drone down here. So he's playing kind of in the dark. And against bad players, that usually doesn't matter too much because they don't play very reactively. They just kind of do their build and hope that it works out. But he did scout for it and he didn't see it, so that might work in my favor. He may play a little bit more conservatively just because he doesn't know what's going on. Especially if I can keep this zealot out. I think I will go fast mutas again, given that it didn't really have the chance to pay off the previous game. And as I explained last time, this map is really just a massive fuck if the Protoss managed to get up to a third base and go into a macro game, just because it's so difficult, basically impossible to put any pressure on them in the early mid game. And most of CVP is decided there. You can, of course, Swarm Host Turtle. This is one of the better maps for that, in fact. But fuck that. And so we see a quick third base. That's good. That means I will have time to get up to the fast mutas. And I'm playing pretty risky, pretty greedy. So that's a really good thing for me. And the only fear here... what he should be doing is he should be sending out his hallucinated Phoenix. And then if he saw the super fast lair, just go 2-star immediately. Because if I go... that's pretty much what happened last game, except with a later third. But with the super early third like this, even if I go like a swarm host timing or quick hydra timing or some shit like that, it'd be pretty difficult for me to keep up with his economy, because I would have to do damage early on, because his third base is going to be up and running not too far after mine, which is a really, really bad position to be in CVP. But I now have full free base economy up. So he did go Stargate right away. That's interesting. Also very annoying. Now hopefully this is just like one star Void Rate or Harass, but more likely than not it is at least two star. He's actually going air. The question is how quickly he'll go into Phoenix. I'm actually going to send in an Overseer and try and figure that out. Oh. He's not actually producing out of that. He's making ground units. That's really, really good for me. That means that he doesn't know it's Muta. He's not going Phoenix. Because if he were just producing 2-star Phoenix right now, I'd be in quite a bit of trouble. Because often when that happens, you can just get out a big round of Corruptors and go Mass Lane and do damage to them. But as is... If my Mutas had been in position, I would have been able to catch the Mothership Core, and that would have just been GG. Really dumb position for the Twilight Council. He has enough units, so I don't think I'm going to be able to kill it just yet. Maybe. This SimCity is just so bad for him. So hopefully he hadn't started his Templar Archives yet. At the very least, it means that he's not going to have Blink for some time. Of course, going meters like this, I do have to do some damage, because right now he should be producing a bunch of Phoenix. We're losing a bunch of them early on like that. Makes life a little bit easier for me. So he should be starting to get up to a scary number of Phoenix. I have to be a little bit careful. Oh, he started production out so late. That he's attacking. Now I just have to survive until Hive Tech and get my Broodlords out. I got some Infestors coming. Got Mortlings on the way because I'm going to be very reliant on counterattacks for a while. I can't actually fight his army, but he also can't keep up with my army, so it's the normal. Oh, I'm going to be able to kill the Nexus. That's awesome. I didn't realize I'd gotten to that low. Taking out the mothership core is really important because the recall is his only real mobility. Damn. But taking out the fleet beacon is good. I can take out the... I actually can expand down here as well, so I have a bit of a fallback for the base race. If that actually happens. I think he might not actually be able to get out of his base before. He's not really moving with any urgency. The attack is gearing up. I have Broodlords coming, I have my Infestors, and I think I have enough static defense to stay alive. So, not sure where exactly he's going to attack. Oh, he left that shit alive. What the fuck is this guy doing? There's no way you can attack into static defense plus Broodlord Corruptor Infestor with that army. No Colossus, the Broodlords will just rip them apart. I just have to make sure that there's no way that he can attack without static defense. That way he can't blink in under me. So we're approaching a max, and he doesn't really have any way. It's okay if he wants to attack into there, because it's a tight enough choke that I can just fungal him. I don't have a ton of economy, so I do need to go put pressure on him. Now that I'm maxed. But I don't see any way he can beat this army now. So it should be okay. Besides running around it. That's right, I don't really have any anti-air. I let him outmaneuver me a bit. That's not so good. I just need to catch this army though. Ah, he stayed too long. That's game. I can just attack one for the win now. Cast a fungal. Doesn't matter. Can't believe he still doesn't have a lot of void rays. It's the only thing that could possibly save him right now. Nope, that was a horrendously boring game. But such is CVP. The control thingy and the volume control mixer, volume mixer, whatever the fuck, it for XSplit is up already, so it's not that. Nothing has changed as far as I know. I don't really know what's wrong with it. Searching for another game now. Another CVP. Okay, this one's on Newkirk, not nearly as bad as Acalon. Thank you. No probe scout this game, so I will have two. I guess I'll just go ahead and 15 hatch. Hopefully it's not proxy 2 gate. I was actually talking about this a bit before, a few games ago. I actually much prefer it when a Protoss probe scouts, because as annoying as a probe scout is in terms of harassing mining and delaying the hatchery, it at least tells you that you have to go pool first, and that there's no way that they're proxy 2 gating. Because if there's no probe scout, the most likely things are either a greed fast expansion or a gateway first, then expansion. Either case, you much prefer going hatchery first and then speeding, or at least hatchery first just because of the economy. However, the other most likely option is that it's actually proxy 2 gate, in which case, of course, hatchery first is just a free loss. So it's a really fucking annoying situation when they don't probe scout and you have to try and guess which is going to be. Still haven't seen anything. Okay, there we go. So it's looking like gateway expansion, probably. Oh, never mind. Proxy 2 gate. What a little fucking... waste of life. What do you actually get out of winning a game like this? We're playing Baz again on this map again. Last time we played on here, I won, but he played just the most obnoxious Mexile. Just mass blue flame Hellbat drops constantly while trying to take expansions. And he's so bad that it didn't work anyway, but it's fucking really, really annoying to play against. And he opened up like Hellion Banshee into Hellbat drop, which is quite dumb, but very annoying. Thank you. Last game, he opened up the same scout timing, and when he was going, or in that game, he was going Reaper. So I'm kind of assuming that it's going to be Reaper again here. Well, if it were Reaper, it should have shown up by now, so perhaps not. Reaper's not a very good opening, particularly on this map. So that's not too surprising. His bunker was much later than it should have been. If I had just gone straight there, I might have been able to do some damage. A couple SCV kills isn't bad, though. More bearish coming up, so we know it's not a fast tech build this game. This is going to be some kind of bio plus Hellion, maybe with medivacs. Either all in or pretty heavy attack. Oh, goddammit. Do something. Death's game. It's just absurdly strong all in. Actually, no. I think I have enough that I can clear out the Hellions. Oh, what the fuck? That was much easier than I remembered. Hellion Marauder is one of those all-ins that I always kind of fear. Like, I always expect it to come back into fashion because it always seems so strong. I guess it's actually not that good. Or maybe this guy just sucks ass. That actually seems like the more likely explanation. But yeah, now that I think about it, he charged in way too aggressively with Marauders. You needed to keep them back and use the Hellions to protect them. That's like the entire point of the build. Anyway, it's a very, very all-in build, so the fact that I've held it off means that unless I die to some kind of follow-up in the next few seconds, which I don't see happening, the game's pretty much over. We see he doesn't have a third base at all yet, nothing like that. And the question is whether he's going to all-in, or he's trying to sit back and turtle up. Either one is not very strong. Okay, so he is going to try and go into a macro game. And it's their base is just getting up now. Really sure why he's taking the one close to me, but pretty sure he's not really going to be able to defend that. Amusing.